Hi thinkers, welcome to the Android development course on thinkxacademy.com. In this video, we are going to start with the Android backend basics. So we have already covered some of the frontend basics, and your frontend skills will get more improved when we will use backend, because we are going to fetch the data from the backend and we will also have to display it in the frontend. So here we are going to use the Wally library, which is supported by Google, and it is a very good library which gives intuitive features like providing cache, which is actually a lot faster, and it gives a faster and cached responses. So we are going to discuss first how this whole backend basics are and how it works, and then we are going to see how we can implement it in Android Studio. In the next tutorial onwards, we are going to make sure that we create an Android application, which will be a to-do application, and inside the to-do application we will be able to insert some tasks, and those tasks will get stored in our databases. So let's get started now. So the first step is, we have this whole diagram here. It is a very important diagram. Make sure that you can draw this somewhere so that you can actually get reference to this. The first step contains Android application that we are going to write. The Android application can generate a GET or a POST request, right? So here we have the Wally library, which is supported by Google. We will install the SDK of this Wally library in the second step. And then what will happen is, the Android application will give a GET or a POST request. Basically, in a POST request, we try to insert something on our data or run something on these tables, for example, updating the data. Whereas inside GET, in GET request, we try to fetch the data from the tables or from the database to the application. Now we have the Wally library here. What Wally library does is, it takes the GET or POST request from the application, which we are going to write in Java. And then it is going to forward this HTTP URL to cache, which is basically a Wally cache. Now Wally has its own cache, and what happens is, first it checks whether the requested URL has been accessed before. So if it has been accessed before, it is going to check from the cache and it can generate or give back the response from here only. But if the cache is not available, it is a cache miss. So then it is going to ask the web server. Now there are various web servers available. We can use the Apache web server. Or if you have any experience in Node.js or any other servers like Flask servers or anything else, you can also use that. So here, instead of this, you can use Node.js as backend, and you can even use Flask for the web development here. Now these are the web servers. So irrespective of what you actually have good hold on, for example, if you have a good hold on Node.js and you have practiced that more, you will still be able to do this all up by yourself, because we are just interested in giving the GET and the POST request using the Wally library, and we will give it a request URL, and it does not matter what server or what implementation you are using it. You are just going to forward this request to the server via a URL, right? For example, let's say we create a URL which is HTTP, and let's say we have installed our server on localhost, and we are now going to create a file which will be insert user file. To insert the user details in the tables, we can just create a user data file. Now here in this series, I am going to use PHP as a backend or a scripting language. So PHP is basically a server-side scripting language, which is used to perform queries, to run queries, to connect to the database and all that stuff. After we have connected to the web server, you can use JS or any other thing to do that, but here I am assuming that you do not have knowledge of these. So what we will do is, we will set up a server which is known as a XAMPP server, on our localhost machine, and then we are going to use PHP. After we will connect, after we will create our Apache server, after we will just connect with this Apache server on localhost, I will just run a PHP script using this URL. This URL is actually forwarded by the Android application to the Molly library. So this is forwarded to the web server. The web server will run this PHP file, which in turn will actually connect to the database. So this is going to be our third step, and in the last step it is going to run the query inside of the table. So it will insert or do some other queries related to the data we are actually transferring, right? So this is how the whole flow of data goes from our Android application via this Molly library to the backend. Now you can design your own backend if you already have experience with it using Node.js, or you can even choose PHP or XAMPP as we're going to do in the upcoming tutorials. So it's all up to you, right? So now let's move on to this very important step, how the Android application gives the request to the Molly library, because we are going to implement it in Java. So the first thing is, which is the step one here, is to create an object string request. So string request is built-in class of Molly library. So we are going to create an object of this class, and to this we are going to give some parameters inside of the constructor. So the constructor will have four types of parameters. The first parameter is going to be the post method. We are going to specify that we are using the post method. We will specify this URL in the second parameter. In the third, we are going to write response lambda. Response will give the response after this string request, after this request is executed by the Molly library. And then we have the fourth and the last one, which is error. So if there is any error in executing this request, we will be able to do some code here, right? So these things will become more clear when we will implement them in Android in the next tutorial. But here I'm just giving you an overview so that you will be able to understand more in those tutorials. After generating the request, the step number two is very simple. We are going to create an object of class request queue. So request queue is again a class of Molly library. We will create an object, and now we will create a new request queue. Basically, request queue is actually a queue where we have all the requests. So first we will create a whole request queue, and then what we will do is we will add this string request, right? So we will add this request, string request. Let's say the object is string request. We will add this inside of this queue. When we will add this inside of this queue, the Molly library will simply execute this request using post method with the given URL. One important step, which is also the step three, is to provide the post parameters, right? So we will have to provide post parameters. So let's say in the insert user.php, we are actually taking post parameters. Let's say we are taking username, and let's say the second one is the password. Now what we are going to do is we will have to pass these two to this post method. For that, what we are going to do is we are going to create a hash map, and this hash map will have a key and values. So keys are going to represent the name of these variables and the values. So it will be name comma the values of the post parameters, and then what we are going to do is we are going to pass these parameters to the string request function. We will see all these steps in the next tutorial. So basically that's all for this tutorial. Thanks for watching, and make sure to subscribe our channel to support us.